one.
Hi, I'm Bert Schietekatte, and I'm with Percussa. We make the Audio Cubes remote and synthesis software. These three components together form a new kind of digital modeler synthesizer. So the cubes are used for patching the modules that are in the synthesizer that is running on the computer.
Are they touch sensitive?
They can be if you switch them to solo mode. So right now they are used for patching the modules when you put the cubes next to each other. Connections is created in the software between the different modules that make the sounds. And as you move the cubes further away and closer to each other, the signals are scaled. So you can change modulation depth.
I'm going to switch sides.
You can change the modulation signals basically by moving the cubes closer and further away. And so you can also switch the cubes into solo mode, and then you can use them kind of as mini theremins. Each cube has four infrared ports. And as you move your hands closer and further away to the ports, you can change the parameters of the sound. And so this remote control surface is the base station for the cube network. You can use up to 15 cubes with this base station. And it allows you to configure the software. So by pressing these buttons, you can step through the different cubes which represent the modules in the software. And then you can change the settings of those modules simply using the encoders here.
On the actual cubes themselves, are there different areas that when you get close to them, besides the infrared sensors, like if I touch this area or the center or the edges, does it have different sounds that come out of there?
No, that won't do anything. So the main things that the cubes have are these four infrared ports that can sense other cubes nearby, as well as sense distance to the cubes or to other objects like your hands.
So that's how you control the different types of the wave or whatever you want to create.
Yes, that's correct. And then in the software, you can also configure the modulation rules, which is a very important part of it. You can determine which cubes and which modules are allowed to modulate which other cubes and modules. So you can tell one cube that it can only modulate the frequencies of another cube or module, or you can tell it that it can only modulate amplitudes or whatever. So you can configure these modules one time like that. You basically set the allowed modulations, and then you can store all that information in a preset. So if I go to global and I switch to a different preset, then you'll see that instantly the whole network of cubes changes colors to indicate the different roles of the cubes.
Very good.
And this is one of the major advantages of the system. You can have all the same hardware, but then switch to different presets and have a completely different modular setup. So instead of having three oscillators, you have like two sequencers or whatever.
And what is the cost for the system?
So we sell two different systems on our website. We have an 8-cube system and a 15-cube system. Both systems come with the remote controller and, of course, the software, which is free. We update the software about 4 times a year, and there will be more modules coming in the software as we release updates. And the 8-cube system is $3,600, and the 15-cube system is $5,600.
Awesome. Thank you so much. And your name and the name of the company is again?
I'm Bert Schietekatte. I'm with Percussa.